KwaZulu-Natal was once hailed as the province with the largest number of voters. As more people have moved to the City of Gold to pursue jobs and money, Gauteng has overtaken KwaZulu-Natal as the most vote-valuable province. The predominantly Zulu province was also once an Inkatha Freedom Party stronghold, but numbers have steadily declined for Mangosuthu Buthelezi's party since 2004. This decline can be attributed to a few key factors, not least of which was the election of Jacob Zuma, who was born and raised in KwaZulu-Natal as ANC president in 2007.
There was this perception that the ANC is a closer dominated political party. So many Zulu traditionalists did not like the ANC until Zuma was elected president. And what Zuma did, which was very, very strategic, was to, you know, keep reminding people that he is a rural boy from Kandla, he's a traditionalist. So that made a lot of rural Zulu speaking people identify with him. And culturally, you know, I mean, as you know, he's got multiple wives. So that makes him even more popular among many Zulus in the province.
But Zuma isn't completely to blame for the decline in IFP support. With the formation of Zanele Magwaza Msibi's National Freedom Party, Zakhele Ndlovu says it will only serve to widen the ANC's margin over all opposition in the province.
You have a weakened IFP, and then you have an NFP that has taken almost half of the IFP support. So basically, the opposition becomes neutralized.
But an opinion seemingly shared by everyone we spoke to is that voting in KwaZulu-Natal has very little to do with ideology and policy, and everything to do with the system of dispensing patronage. From ward councillors to mayors to normal people on the street, everyone shared the opinion that if you don't belong to the party that rules the ward you reside in, you are likely to get nothing.
Ngisho kumanje manje ngithinge nenkinga lingenze lutho lazi ngitshela ngeingane nje nali kodla ingane lapha sizathola ingane ayisebenzi iqedile u10 asinalutho olubikekayo thina lizwaka lolwethu asinazo ngisho izindlu nje kuba nesibona sakhele uthini kodwa benkatha makuqashwa lapha ezantsi kwamasipala uthatha benkatha amantombazane nezethu uyifundile kodwa ayithathu ezethu ziyosebenza thina mayikhipha ze-ANC siyazilithola umsebenzi kodwa ze-NFP ziyawuthola inkatha yebo ungakho bese uyomasha nje ngolesihlanu sagula sibuya khona emashini osowulundi ingane ezithu waphila nathi amanzi asinawo siyancintshwa amanzi konke asinalutho nje thini aphuma ngalelo langa ubani wabona nje yebo umadonsela akezeke ngoba ukwazile ukuthi ephenye umsholozi umadonsela akezophenya i-NFP la ukuthi kwenzekani ngoba uyakwazi ukuphenya umadonsela ephenye ongafuni yena
mina ngokubona kwami la kule wadi le cause like iwad la iphethe u-IFP so thina si inhlangano ya ANC because ANC la awumningi so kunalokho ukuthi thina esiwu ANC because bayasazi banokusho ukuthi indawo ethile kuno ANC so sigcina singayitholi idingo zethu because kunabantu abaqashiwe kuqashwa abantu baka ANC kunenye ka AFP excuse so kunenye member ebiqashiwe yaka ANC umuntu omusha njenganami kukhatha utshanda emgwaqeni so bathe mabethola ukuthi uyena uzongena lapho ba complain yawo indaba yamasipala mina angiyazi ngeke ngize ngikhulume because ngisho ngasi sisikhalo sina sinenkosi ngasi sisikhalo ngokugcina kuphelele enkosini ngeke kufike kulowo masipala loyo.
The dispensation of patronage also seems to be at the heart of political violence that plagues the dense and vast KwaMashu hostel northwest of Durban, where 8 people have been murdered this year alone. Jabo Nkwango, an NFP supporter, claims this patronage is closely guarded by the IFP, for whom Ward 39 represents the party's only stronghold in the eThekwini municipality. March's Ward 39 by-election was dogged with allegations of intimidation, vote rigging, and violence all being levelled at the IFP. But IFP block chairperson Sifiso Sibaya rubbishes these claims.
Oh, Jame. Ngokwami ukubuka ngicabanga ukuthi mhlawumbe kuye kube khona ungaboni ngasolinye nokungavuthwa-ke mhlawumbe kwabantu ukuthi kufanele kuhlaliswane kanjani endaweni ngoba okubalulekile ukuthi sazane ukuthi singabantu sihloniphane siqhubeke nempilo ngoba ukudala udlame ngeke usize ngalutho la kwesethu isigceme la wese testime besabona thina kungekho okubi kakhulu ngoba sihlezi nabo sihlangano ehlukene kathathu NFP ANC IFP kodwa nje sihleli kamnandi thina njengoba songo block chairman nje futhi asichemile uma senza imhlangano thina sibabiza bonke sibatshele ngezwe lolozo sisebenza njenge council.
As we draw nearer to elections, mudslinging and accusations of maladministration are rife. On April 21st, in an open veld in Ubuka, between Impangeni and Melmoth, Buchelezi drew a modest crowd of perhaps 300 people. With hardly any media present and feeling no need to defer to a facade of civility, Buchelezi went for Magwaza Msibi's jugular, accusing her of using municipal funds to campaign for the NFP. If these allegations are true, he said to his audience, then it's no wonder her banners are bigger and more prominent than those of the ruling party. There's no doubt the ANC will take KwaZulu-Natal in next week's election. The big question is between the NFP and IFP, who will come in second? Hey, hey! Hey, hey! Hey, hey! Hey, hey!